Hey everybody, it's pembrokewkorgi, and I'm here with a box. This box came from my friend Krunchy. Having a collection of figures like this all of a sudden. First I get like Celestia, and now I got my freaking favorite Darkstalker, Felicia. Nice. Well, having a box will make her easier to for me to transfer to my new place. Whenever that happens. Wherever I get to go. Ooh, nice. I like that they got the claw marks all in the box. That's really nice. That's a good presentation. Someone knows what's up. You guys see this? It is so much detail to this thing. It looks absolutely amazing. Man. Oh dude, there's even like even that little you can like even see like the fur. See like the fur lines in there. Oh, it's so good. It's so pretty. That is absolutely amazing. I look forward to finding a good spot to put this whenever I get to my new place. It'll be nice. Hey man, this is so nice. I like that they even gave her kind of a darker skin tone. I think that's actually really cool too. Usually she's really white skinned. Light skinned, probably guess is a better way to phrase it. This looks amazing. Like I said, Felicia's my favorite Darkstalker. I have a few figures of her. But this one takes the cake. This is by far the best one. Lord, I hope you didn't pay too much, Krunchy, because man, this looks amazing. All the detail on her crazy fluffy ass hair. Oh, it's so good. I might even like this more than the Celestia one. Actually, I think I actually do. When I was like a teenager, when I was a lot younger, like young adult, I was way obsessed with Felicia. She was my waifu, you could say. But she's also the one that like introduced me to the concept of, you know, cat girls in general. So, dang, this looks so good. There is so much detail on this. Oh, it's so good. Like space between your like everything here is just it's so good. It's so good. Doesn't she look this good in a Marvel vs. Capcom 3? Oh, I can't lie, she looks good in that game. This is like really good. Just look at how detailed this is. Man, this is amazing. Man. I'm getting nothing but good gifts. Good gifts this year. Everybody be giving me good gifts this year, jeez. Though I know for a fact that this one was something that Krunchy ordered for me like a year in advance. Because that's how the pre-orders for a lot of these figures do, is you have to pre-order them like a year in advance. Or you can, anyways. Because seemingly he's also pre-ordered another one for me, but we'll look into that one whenever I receive it. This is really freaking nice. Jeez, Krunchy, this is awesome. I love it so much. It's so detailed. The only thing that sucks is I have to put it back in the box. Kotobukiya, Darkstalkers, Bishoujo, Statue of Felicia. Stylized by Junya Yamashita. Forgive me if I mispronounce these things, but yeah. The art on the box actually is really super cute, too. Look at that. So good. Oh, man, this figure is absolutely amazing. Thank you again, Krunchy. And I hope you guys also liked watching and looking at this. And I'll see you guys next time. See ya. Hey, everybody. I realized I forgot something very important on that Felicia video. As you know, I've been moving, and while moving, I realized, oops, I forgot to show the other Felicia merchandise I have, as I usually do with these type of videos. So now I'm going to show off the few other pieces of Felicia merchandise from Darkstalkers that I have. Unfortunately, I can't show them next to the statue that Krunchy gave me because I've already packed that up. Sorry. So I'm afraid I can't do it a comparison, but I can still show you the three other pieces that I have. First off, we've got this Felicia gashapon figure. I had to zoom up on this because this thing is really tiny. For those who don't know, gashapon are these little capsule toys that they sell a lot in Japan. You pretty much open up the capsule, it has little pieces to the figure, you put them together, and there you go. I used to collect gashapons a lot when I was younger, especially during my weeb phase. Does everybody go through one of those? Where you just think anime is like the greatest thing ever? Anyways. And nowadays, I don't collect gashapons as much, mostly because I kind of find their quality to be a mixed bag. Like, you'll either get something that's really good, or sometimes you get stuff that just looks like garbage, or just very simplistic or off. This one, however, I think looks really, really good. And yeah, I like all the details on it. Because like I said, for gashapon, it is very, very detailed. They've got all these little details in the hair, they've got the light blue strands that she has. Very nice. Very good. Hopefully this won't upset people on YouTube. Because, you know, she technically is naked. That, she's only being covered by fur. Meow indeed. I could make a pussycat joke, but I'm too dignified for that. Anyways. The next figure we have in Felicia is another gashapon. I had to bring this box out to stand her behind, put behind her, because for whatever reason, despite the fact she's been standing on my shelf for literal years, she's decided that she doesn't want to stand up now. Despite the fact I have to stand in everything. This goes into one of the issues I do sometimes have with gashapons, is some of them just after time don't want to stand or just are fidgety. This one likes to fall apart a lot. Like, you barely touch it and, like, the arm will fall off or something. It's cool. I like the fact that it's referencing the ending to Vampire Savior, which, for those who don't know, at the end of Vampire Savior, it's revealed that Felicia becomes a nun. Either that or she's doing a movie where she's dressed as a nun. But it seemingly insinuates that she now works as an orphanage and they call her sister, so. Which would make sense because she originally grew up in an orphanage and now that she's become a movie star or whatnot, it makes sense that she would also want to go to an orphanage. So all those people that have a thing for Felicia, sorry, she's already taken by God, seemingly. This makes her the original demon nun, when you think about it. Because, I mean, considering that, you know, the Darkstalkers are all supposed to be like demons and monsters, and yet she's a nun, it's kind of hysterical in a way. But Felicia's a good girl. She's a good girl, so of course she'd be a nun. Yeah, this one is... the details are not as good, like, she doesn't have the extra... Like, there's some detail in the hair, but she's missing, like, the... Those, extra light blue strands, and it's not near as fluffy. And it's good, but the face isn't as good, and I don't know. It's good, but it's not as, I feel like it's not as good as it could be. It's especially annoying that it just does not want to stand on its own power, and that is always an issue. But it's still good, and like I said, it's cool that it references, you know, the ending to Vampire Savior, which if you haven't beat it with her, you won't know. So, oh no, this figure is also a spoiler. Oops.
Next is this big hawking statue. I don't remember if my ex-wife got it for me or if I bought it while I was married. I don't remember.
This is a really, really detailed Felicia statue. To the point where it almost feels kind of naughty. but yeah, it's really detailed. Got all the strands. It's not quite as detailed as the one that Krunchy gave me, because there's not like all the fur texturing and everything like that one has, but it's still really, really nice. It's got lots of muscle detail like crazy, which does kind of make... Yeah, it kind of makes the crotch area feel a little bit like, should this, oof, it's a little naughty. But nah, it's not. Everything's still covered, everything's still good, but it is such a pretty statue. It's such a really pretty statue. Like I said, this is probably, the one Krunchy got me is by far my favorite, because that thing looks absolutely amazing. But this one is definitely my second to favorite. So yeah, that's all of my Felicia figures. Amazing statue, the one Krunchy got me. And then these two gashapons, which this one is totally not going to stand on its own power. So I'll just help yourself stand. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Hang out with yourself. So yeah, there's my collection of Felicia figures. I mean, what can you say? It's the cat's meow. But no, I love Felicia. I think she's adorable. She's very cute. She's a very good girl. And I mean that in that she is literally the purest. It's so amazing that Capcom created this character that's literally running around naked with giant jubblies, and yet her personality is literally the most cinnamon roll, freaking adorable, naive, wholesome, cute girl you could possibly meet. She is the goodest of girls. And yeah, so there's my collection of Felicia figures. Not as much as some of my other stuff, but you know, it's still cool. I really, really wish Capcom would just make us another Darkstalkers game. But that ain't gonna happen. And it makes me sad. But hey, maybe they can put them in Street Fighter. It would be a little weird tone-wise. Not that there's not already weird stuff in Street Fighter. Anyways, there you go, and I'll see you guys next time.